This video will teach you about the structure of the eye. We'll learn about the position and role of some key parts of the eye, common eye defects, and how these parts work together to allow the eye to respond to change. The eye is a sensory organ. By processing light and converting it into impulses that our brains can understand, eyes enable us to see the world. To achieve this feat, many intricate parts work together. To figure out how an eye works, we'll begin with some anatomy. Look at this cross-section of an eyeball. Eyeballs are protected by eyelids, which stop dust from entering, and a white outer protective coat. Bulging out on the right-hand side, we see the cornea, a transparent outer layer. As light enters the eye, the cornea refracts or bends it. Behind the cornea is the iris, the coloured visible part of the eye. Shaped like a flattened donut, it regulates how much light enters. The hole in the centre of the iris through which light passes is the pupil. After passing through the pupil, light reaches the lens, a convex transparent disc made of jelly-like material. Just like a camera's lens, it functions to refract light. With the help of ciliary muscles, the lens's shape is manipulated to focus on near or distant objects. On the opposite side of the eye is a thin layer of tissue called the retina. Light rays converge on the retina, which is loaded with thousands of light-sensitive cells, photoreceptors. Photoreceptors then do the crucial work of converting this light energy into electric signals that the brain receives through the optic nerve. There are two types of photoreceptors, rods and cones, named for their shapes. Cones are responsible for color vision and come in three varieties, red, green, and blue. Rods, on the other hand, only detect light and dark, not color, and help form images under dim conditions. Liquid, called the aqueous humor, fills the space between the cornea and lens. The rest of the eyeball is filled with a watery gel, called the vitreous humor. That's each part of the eye and what it does. The eye is complex, and sometimes things go wrong. Myopia, also known as nearsightedness, is a common condition caused by light rays converging in front of the retina, so distant objects appear out of focus. Hyperopia, or farsightedness, is the opposite condition. Rays converge behind the retina, so close-up objects appear blurry. As we age, our risk of other errors rises, like a refractive error called presbyopia, or a curvature error called astigmatism that blurs vision. Other potential problems include glaucoma, where the optic nerve becomes damaged, cataracts, when the lens becomes clouded, and macular degeneration, where the retina breaks down. When working well, eyes are responsive. Let's observe how the eye responds to change. The eye can respond to different light levels. Too much or too little light can hinder someone's vision, so the muscles of the iris adjust the pupil size accordingly. In bright light, the iris contracts the pupil, reducing how much light enters the eye. In dim light, the iris expands the pupil, ensuring that more light can enter the eye. The eye can also respond to different object distances. To focus on a nearby object, the ciliary muscles relax, and the lens becomes thicker, refracting light strongly. To focus on a distant object, the ciliary muscles contract, so the lens is thinner, only slightly refracting rays. You should now better understand the parts of the eye, how they can malfunction, and how they respond to change. It's important to take good care of this intricate, delicate, and sophisticated sensory organ.